Hello, hello everyone. I am Ernestine Graham with Spirit Wind Healing Ministry, Spirit Wind Apostolic Training Center here in Peoria, Arizona. And this is your Friday Food for Thought. How many of you remember that man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that proceeds from the Father's mouth? So what does that mean? That means that God's word is nourishment for our souls, and we need to get it in our souls every single day. We need to feed our spirit, man. We need to change and transform our soul by the word of God. Our mind, will, and emotions need to line up with that. So that's why I give these words every Friday. I did do a live, and so if you're looking for that video, I had to delete it. It was really poor quality, lagging, and I try to put out decent quality, as good as I can get it on my own, so that you're not interrupted by all those distractions that come from live videos or videos that are not of good quality. So I'm not perfect at it. Eventually I'll get going better on the lives. I tried it from my laptop, didn't work. So anyway, one of the first things that we do in ministry when working with people in the deliverance ministry is to have them search their heart for unforgiveness. So we talk about that. A lot of times deliverance and healing requires some detective work, helping work with the Holy Spirit to get in the soul of an individual to discover what is hindering them, what is the problem in their lives. Unforgiveness leads to a bitter root. It causes a bitter root, and a bitter root will defile many. And so we have to be willing to forgive. And the one thing that people always, they look at you like, what do you mean forgive? They don't deserve forgiveness, right? Well, that's what our self-righteousness would say, is another human being doesn't deserve our forgiveness, but we deserve the forgiveness of Jesus Christ. And that's where Satan gets a grip into people's lives. So I want to talk to you about that. I want to ask you to share this video. Help me get the word out about Spirit Wind Healing Ministries and Spirit Wind Apostolic Training Center, because we are training people on the area of deliverance and healing, but we're also training them in the Word of God. We make room for evangelists, prophets, apostles, teachers, pastors, people who can preach and who are called to it. We make room for them on our podium. So that is a part of what we're doing, teaching, training, equipping, and sending out. So let's look at what Jesus said. The first thing that Jesus said was, the first time you see Jesus Christ talking about prayer, it's in Matthew 6. And what he said was this. He said, don't be like the pagans when you pray. So in other words, you got to pray. But when you pray, don't be like the pagans. Because they think that because of their many words that, I cannot see my screen. Because of their many words, do not be like them, for the Father knows what you need before you ask him. He says this, then this is how you should pray. And that's the disciples that asked him how to pray. A lot of times when you're a new believer, you don't really know how to pray. And so that is one of the first questions that you ask. How do I pray? So he said this, our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. So you declare God's holiness. You thank him. You lift him up. You exhort him. He says, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So you acknowledge God's kingdom and you want his kingdom to come down to earth. You want his kingdom manifested in your life. And then he says, give us our daily bread. Well, this is the word of God. This is what we live on. And whatever other needs that we might have to survive. And forgive us our debts as we have forgiven our debtors. And forgive us our debts as we have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. There's a temptation to not forgive people. And I'm not saying that's exactly what he's talking about here thoroughly, but that is one point that can be made, that there is a temptation to hold somebody hostage to their history. You don't have the right to hold another human being to their history. For if you forgive other people when they sin against you, your Heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others for their sins, your Father will not forgive your sins either. I didn't write it. I'm just saying it. Matthew 6, verses 13 through 15. Unfortunately, many people are not hearing this. And many people are being tormented by demonic spirits because they will not forgive as they have been commanded to forgive. People are going to sin against you. They're going to hurt you. They're going to betray you. They're going to break your trust. It's going to happen in the church. It's going to happen outside of the church. It's going to happen in your family. It's going to happen. There's nothing we can do about it. Jesus said, if they hated me, they'll hate you. People are fallen and they're wounded themselves, and wounded people wound people. They often cause pain because they're reactive out of their emotions. They're reactive out of their pain. Christians aren't walking by the Spirit of God. The Bible says, walk by the Spirit, you will not fulfill the lust of the flesh. The lust of the flesh wants to get even. The lust of the flesh wants to have vengeance. The lust of the flesh is prideful. The lust of the flesh wants to lash out and be heard. But we're told not to be that way. So then Jesus is having a conversation with his disciples, and Peter says to him, Lord, how many times shall I forgive my brother and sister when he sins against me? When they sin against me, and he says up to seven times. Should I just do it like seven times? Is that the end? Is there a marker? And I don't have to forgive him anymore? Okay, I've forgiven you seven times. I'm done. I'm done. I will not forgive you anymore. No, he says, Jesus answered and said, I tell you not seven times, but 77 times. Matthew 18, 21 through 22. What? That's a lot of times. Who's keeping track? Love does not keep a record of wrongdoings. Amen. Love forgives until you don't need to forgive anymore. You may need to forgive somebody 100 times over. What he's saying is forgive them until you're complete in it, until you're good in it, until it doesn't disturb your soul anymore. You know what? If you lay down your expectations of somebody not doing you wrong and not hurting you, you won't constantly need to forgive that person. Amen? So as the conversation goes on, Jesus begins to tell the disciples about a parable about a servant who was forgiven much. His debt was released. He had a large debt, and his master forgave him. But then he had the opportunity to pay that forward and forgive somebody who owed him a lot less than he owed. And instead of doing so, he refused and had that person thrown in jail. And that's just such a sad, sad state of affairs. He could have paid it forward, so to speak. It says this, when the other servants saw what had happened, that this man had not forgiven his servant after he had been forgiven, they went and told their master everything about what had happened. And then their master called this guy in. He said, you wicked servant. He said, I canceled all of your debt like you begged me to. Shouldn't you have had mercy on your fellow servant just as I had you? And so in his anger, his master handed him over to the jailers to be tortured until he paid back all that he owed. This is how my Heavenly Father will treat each of you unless you forgive your brother or sister from your heart. Matthew 18, 31 through 35. So what does that mean? Well, if you don't forgive another human being, you have an open door to be tortured by the demonic spirits. You have an open door to be tortured even by your own soul, as your own soul plays it out over and over again. And demonic spirits can poke you in those wounds, in those places of unforgiveness, to keep you in a bondage place where bitterness roots in there. And once you've not forgiven somebody for a long length of time, chances are very good that you've gotten what is called a bitter root judgment. You've made a judgment against that person. You've decided, not God, you have decided you get the right to hold them hostage to unforgiveness. And you can hold their history over their heads all the time. But Jesus said he cast your sins as far as the east is to the west. I've been wounded. I have been abused. I have been abused at every level. There's not any type of abuse I have not suffered in my lifetime. And I have learned to bless and not curse. It's not easy. Please hear me. It's not easy. But if you love God, you'll follow his word. You'll let him heal you by doing what he commands you to do. He knows what's best for our souls. So hopefully you get the point of this message with Jesus. He spent almost a full chapter here discussing the sin of not forgiving. And then there was this woman who had been a prostitute, and she poured expensive perfume all over Jesus' feet and washed it with her hair because she understood the depth of her depraved soul and how she had been forgiven for her sin. Now, I want to talk a little bit about it, but I want to show you. When she was doing this, there were some around that were mocking her and that were angry because she wasted all this expensive perfume and it could have fed the poor. And Jesus says, therefore, I tell you, many sins have been forgiven. Her many sins have been forgiven as her great love has shown. But whoever has been forgiven little loves little. Luke 7:47. As her great love has shown, she washed the feet of her master with this very expensive perfume, used the hair to wipe it up, which is actually the glory of a woman. It's said that her hair is the glory. In other words, there's a covering there, and she gave it all to him. and she humiliated herself before the Lord, and she didn't care what everybody else was thinking. Now, this was a woman who had a very harlotry type of past, a whoredom. She would have been a pagan and a heathen and operating, but she was probably extremely wounded. She would have been used and abused by men, and she put herself in a very vulnerable position, and yet she did so because she had been forgiven so much. So see, when you know how much you've been forgiven, when you understand the capacity of your own self-righteous soul to hinder God's ability to work in your life, then when you get that, then you can receive Jesus in a fuller measure. Then you can receive his love and forgiveness. Then you can release it. So I pray for you on your Jesus journey. Will you take some time to allow the Holy Spirit to search your heart and forgive those that you need to forgive? Stop holding people hostage to their history. And if you must separate from some relationships, do so, but do it with a forgiving heart. God bless you.